인도 상원 의장 발언을 준비합니다. 이어서 인도네시아 하원 의장님을 준비해 주시기 바랍니다. 인도의 싱 하리반시 상원 의장님 발언을 주십니다.
His Excellency, the Chairman of the Majlis Parliament of Kazakhstan, Mr. Nur-Sultan, co-hosts, speakers, Deputy Speakers, delegates, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege for me to participate in the fourth meeting of speakers of Eurasian countries, Parliament being held here in this beautiful city of Nur-Sultan. I take this opportunity to congratulate the Chairman of Majlis of Kazakhstan for hosting this meeting and for great hospitality. Your Excellency, before I make my submission, I wish to make some comments about the very responsible statement made by my Pakistani counterpart. I'm constant to raise this because we feel that they have tried to hijack this meeting and raise issues which are not only totally unrelated to the subject matter of this forum, but are absolutely internal matters of ours. Ironically, Pakistan has no authority, moral or otherwise, to dwell on Jammu and Kashmir, which is an integral part of India. I did not want to say this, but since my Pakistani counterpart has been insistent, the entire world knows that it is Pakistan that has illegally occupied our part of Jammu and Kashmir, and they have finished the identity and self-respect of local people there. Terrorism is an international concern and biggest threat to humanity today. State-sponsored terrorism and cross-border terrorism have today become a threat not only to India, but to the entire humanity. What is most ironical and strange, Excellency, is that this issue is being raised by a country which is known exporter of terrorists and is the epicenter of terrorism for the entire world. The theme of this meeting, Greater Eurasia Dialogue Trust Partnership, is very topical and appropriate, given the critical importance of Eurasia in the emerging global economy and geopolitics. Our role and contributions as presiding officers and the parliamentarians will be of great significance in this endeavor. India attaches a great deal of importance to our relations with the countries of Eurasian region. We have a long historical, cultural, economic, trade and civilizational linkages with the countries of this region. We have always endeavored to promote and develop this cooperation and engagement. India is keen to put in place a trade arrangement with the Eurasian Economic Union. We are actively engaged bilaterally and multilaterally to promote connectivity in this region through various mechanisms and such as International North-South Transport Corridor, INSTC, ASCA-QUAD Agreement, United Nations Transport, Internet, Routiers, TIR Convention, etc. Let me share India's vision for a more secure and prosperous Eurasian space as well as its concerns. Globalization is under stress due to new and emerging geopolitical and geoeconomic fault lines. India supports a rule-based order in the region as in the rest of the world, but we confront unavoidable challenges such as terrorism, conflicts, transnational crimes, and maritime threats. There are also issues of climate change, sustainable development, energy security, gender equality, and connectivity. These must be urgently addressed for our common good. Climate change has posed significant development challenges, especially for developing countries. Developing countries need resources and technical assistance to achieve sustainable development. India has a long tradition of preserving Mother Earth for future generations. Sustainable development remains at the center for all initiatives and programs. Our development actions are guided by the philosophy Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas, which means inclusive growth. Our Prime Minister, His Excellency Sri Narendra Modi ji's nationwide multi-sectoral initiative, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, Save the Girl Child, Educate Her, has been conceived to tackle the issue of child sex ratio and education of girls. Awareness, raising and advocacy and mindset change are pivotal elements of this campaign. Parliament, as a supreme representative body, guides the national agenda for development and governance. As people's representatives, it is our solemn duty and collective responsibility as parliamentarians to promote and strengthen parliamentary cooperation for addressing challenges of terrorism, climate change, sustainable development, gender discrimination, and ensuring growth and common prosperity. I hope our meeting today will strengthen our resolve to collectively work towards these goals. I would like to convey through this August meeting, India believes in Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the world is family since 1,000 years. With these words, I once again thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts on this issue. Thank you.